Hey, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everybody. Oh, let me just do a Jeff bubble here for a minute. And this is the dog we're going to be talking about. A lot of you have seen this dog on our Facebook page. We document, you know, tons of our work. And a lot of people were making comments about, wow, that dog's like really out of control and, you know, good luck. And, you know, the great thing about our fan base is, like, everybody knows that it's great that the dogs are always on our property because they're going to make great progress. But let me just... I'm going to show a video. I'm going to just show a quick 15-second video of this dog that came in. And this dog is extremely similar to almost every single dog that comes in. Every single dog that comes in. So what I want everybody to know is if you're struggling with your dog, there's really no reason to be struggling with your dog anymore. Now, this dog is human aggressive, some dog aggressive, a lot of fear-based stuff, needs help with its obedience. But we're not going to talk about that today. All we're gonna do is talk about how to get your dog to easily walk on a leash. So no matter what your training methodology is, it shouldn't take that long. It should actually only take minutes to get your dog from pulling and lunging and reactivity with 99% of the dogs to walk politely on the leash. I'm gonna show a quick video now of the intake, and you'll see the dog, we call it nonsense. It's minor leash reactivity, we call it nonsense. But the big issue is this. If you're struggling with your dog, I personally don't care how you train, what your training methodology is, but it shouldn't take more than, let's say, an hour to get the dog to be walking politely on a leash. Right now, we're going to be doing it in our training center. Hey, Leslie, but it doesn't make a difference if it's at the training center or outside. We're going to do some walk-bys with another dog. This dog came in on a front clip harness. Now, if you can get your dog to politely walk on a leash in less than a day, going from leash reactivity to a front clip harness, do it. Absolutely do it. The issue is we're not seeing harnesses help dog training. That's not what we're seeing. We're seeing it either stay the same or making it worse. So a lot of people, the reason why they use harnesses is because the dog was choking on a collar. So what they do is they're like, if I don't use a collar anymore and if I put the dog on a harness, the dog won't choke. I agree 100%. The problem is they can't train the dog. They can't get information to the dog. So if you're struggling with your dog right now, we highly recommend using a prong collar. The reason why we like using a prong collar, because we feel it is one of the best ways to communicate with your dog. If you've heard negative stuff about the prong collar, that's fine. But we've trained over 4,000 dogs, and we're not seeing any dog, zero dogs, harmed on a prong collar. Some of the lies out there are like, oh, the dog only listens because the prong collar hurts the dog. That's a lie. No, it doesn't. Why does a prong collar work? Let's just make it really simple. Because it does. Now, we use clickers. We use food. We use a balanced approach. So what we're going to do now is I'm going to show you a quick video, and then I'm going to show you within a day, within minutes actually, how easy this was to do it. And all we did was change tools, have good leash handling skills, and then teach the dog how to easily walk on a leash. It doesn't take long. This happened the first training session that we did. So here we go. This is the intake, and almost all of our intakes look like this. This is just basic. We call this just nonsense. We just call this nonsense. So many dogs walk down the street like this. This is no big deal. So yes, the dog is aggressive, but we're not gonna even address the aggression right now. We're gonna address the dog's state of mind, and we're gonna address the dog's reactivity. All right, that's all we're gonna address in this video right now, because I want people to be able to get started. I want people to be able to get started on this. Okay, so John, come on over here. And let's just talk about this dog. So this is the same dog. So let's have the dog go into an SIT. Okay, so you'll notice this dog has a 2.25 millimeter prong collar, and that's a smaller gauge prong collar. You'll notice the collar is up nice and high. Okay, it's up nice and high and snug. You'll notice now, John, how he holds the leash. Let me back up a little bit. So what John does is, in his left hand, he's giving this dog about 12 inches of leash, and then he holds the leash in the other hand. John, can you show the one-handed hold where you wrap the leash like in small circles.
Yeah, so I tend to always go to this reference point. You always want to have a good lock on the leash. This is the two-handed heel, so my arms can stay nice and relaxed.
Yep.
Leash is going to stay loose.
Right.
If I do one hand, I go to that reference point. So like Jeff said, about with this dog, it's about 12 inches.
Yep.
Go to that reference point, and then I go light loop.
Right.
And I always go back to that thumb.
Yep. So you can do it one-handed or two-handed. What we don't want you to do is joystick. John, can you show what joysticking the leash would look like? See how he's holding the leash like that? So now he's not, see how the dog resists? The reason why the dog resists is because you're pulling the dog and then it goes, I don't want to be pulled. So you want to have the loose leash on the dog. Now what you're doing is you're keeping that, we prefer the left. It really doesn't make a difference if the dog's on the left or the right. Literally this dog went from, let me just show everybody this again, which is no big deal in our world. This is normal. This is actually pretty tame when it comes to a dog walking. So this is pretty tame. So if your dog is doing this or even worse, just switch tools for now. But it's not just the tool. It's important that you hold the leash proper. And now it's also important that you walk proper. So notice how John, start walking, John. Notice how John's left hand is going to be down nice and relaxed. It's nice and relaxed. Okay? It's nice and relaxed. See that? See how nice and relaxed that is? So John is giving gentle little pops, which don't hurt the dog. For all the people out there, they're like, oh, you're hurting the dog. No, you're not. And now what you're doing is you're getting the dog to finally focus on, this dog's been here for a couple of days, but this happened on day one. I just didn't have the opportunity to film him. This happens usually at the first time we work with a dog, with leash reactivity, this normally happens, just like this. Now you're gonna get a little bit of resistance on the dog. The reason why you're getting resistance is because there's another dog right here. Okay, so let's do a quick drive-by, Jordan. So watch the dog now. John is gonna give the dog information. Good, he didn't have to. Let's set this up now. Now what I want people to understand is this. Can you come a little bit closer to me, John, please? Come a little bit closer, okay. And then Jordan, right there. Now, Jordan, walk by. And then watch the dog's head. See how it started going towards this dog? John gives the dog information with a leash, and it's a pop, not a pull, that just says, mind your own business. Mind your own business. We don't mind looking, but you can't load up on another dog. You can't be staring at another dog. If the dog happens to look up at John, he'll probably mark it with a yes. What we don't do is right now, and we do food for training, but right now we're not doing food because I'm just trying to do a quick video. But again, food with a dog that's all aroused is not good. Food with a dog that's thinking naughty thoughts is not good. You don't need to use food for this. We use food, we use clickers. But for this exercise right now, for this video, I just want to show people that you should not be struggling with your dog on a leash. You shouldn't be. Now, does this dog look nervous? Yeah. Does this dog look uncertain? Yeah. But it's not because of the prong collar. Listen, this dog right here, in this video, was also nervous and uncertain. It just manifested in this behavior. So this is a nervous dog as well. It's not an excited dog, okay? So thoughts on, we don't use transitional leashes. We don't use transitional leashes. If it works for you, keep doing it. A transitional leash though actually puts pressure on the dog all the time. So if you use it and it works, that's fine. But as long as you recognize that it's always putting pressure on the dog. So that's up to you to use it if you want to. We're just not fans of it. But the bottom line is, if you can walk your dog perfectly down the street and you use a transitional leash, keep doing it. Because we just want dogs to behave. Like this dog just has a slip lead on. Like we just want dogs to behave. That's all. And we don't want you to have to take months or sometimes years to get your dog to be able to walk politely on a leash. Oh, thank you, Travis.
Yeah.
Transitional leash, you just Google it. Just Google it. It's pretty much you're taking a slip lead and putting it over the dog's nose. But what it does is it creates pressure on the dog at all times. And if you're doing the concept of pressure on, pressure off, then it doesn't go with our training program. That doesn't mean it doesn't work. So this is it. This is all I wanted people to see is I just wanted people to see that, you know, you don't have to struggle anymore. That's all I wanted people to see. So this happens day one after drop off.
Yep.
Now, this dog obviously has human aggression issues, dog aggression issues, lack of obedience, but that's not the point. Obviously, we still have to work on those things, and we will. But this was more about, there was so much response to this video about the dog, its reactivity, and in our scale of about a 1 to 10 of reactivity, that was about a 3. Meaning there's a lot more dogs that come in here with major, major reactivity. But even those dogs, with the proper tool, all right, with the proper tool, all right, and the technique is fine. So your dog walks well on a leash with prong, no pulling, lunging, etc. Well, Donnie, yeah, catch up, man. Donnie, we're doing thousands of videos, thousands and thousands of videos. So this is a great Facebook Live, and I just want to get that information out to everybody. This the gist of this video was, if your dog is lunging on a leash, if your dog is pulling on a leash, if your dog is being reactive, it doesn't need to. It doesn't need to be. There's not just our videos, but there's other people's videos out there that can show you how to stop it, how to stop it. And it doesn't take long. So that took 5 minutes into the first time we started working the dog. In 5 minutes, it went from reactivity to non-reactivity. So that's the point. That's the gist of it. So, okay. Just wanted to get that out there. Show a little bit of progress. Obviously, this dog is here for a little bit because we've got human aggression issues and dog aggression issues, and we'll keep everybody updated in how we do that. And if you follow us on, especially Periscope, follow us on Periscope because we put so much content on there about the daily progress of dogs. You can see how all the dogs on the property are progressing, as well as little tidbits of information. If anybody's going to be in Elkhart, Indiana, I've got a seminar this weekend, so I fly out tomorrow at like 4 a.m. All right? Oh, yeah, the dog will walk with confidence. Yeah, and we're not worried. It's like, how about if this dog hates the walk? This is the thing, Joe Bell. How about it? Everybody seems to be dog-centric. I'm human-centric, okay? How about if this dog hates the walk for the next 6 months, but walks perfectly? I don't care. I don't care. Do you know why? I love human beings. I want the owner to enjoy the walk. And so many dog people are so dog-centric, but they don't care about the human. I'm human-centric. Like, if the owner enjoys the walk, but the dog sort of, not the best walk in the world, but it's walking properly, I will take that every day. The dog will eventually enjoy the walk. That's just how it is. It's just how it is. And if people want to humanize this, I will humanize this all day long. I can give you lots of human examples with kids. And no, you don't put prong collars or remote collars on your kids. That's a stupid response. But as far as like, he didn't seem to dislike walking with John. No, he didn't. But I don't care. Even if he hated it, I wouldn't care. John doesn't care. We're at the beginning of training. Like, this is rehab. So when you go into rehab and you're trying to get off alcohol, drugs, smoking, if you don't like your nurse, if you don't like your doctor, they don't care. Tough. Get over it. All right? Yeah, you know, not poor dog. Poor owner. The dog was enjoying itself lunging. The owner hated it. We need to be more owner-focused. So, all right, owners are the ones that are paying the price. Dogs end up paying the price too, but owners really pay the price. All right, take care. Jeff Gellman, Solid Canine Training. Feel free to share this. Any snarkiness down below, we eliminate. Any, you know, arguments about tools, we eliminate. It's just not, this, not, that's, this, our Facebook page is not for that. All right, take care, everybody. Bye-bye. Love you all.